Rio is just this place that seems like it comes out of a movie. And every time you go there, it's kind of unlike anywhere else.
Welcome back to the Oi Rio Pro. This is the opening day of competition in round one. Heat number 12 has just hit the lineup.
Not a whole lot of mistakes coming out of John John right now. You can just see everything's clicking, looking amazing.
John John Florence will breathe a sigh of relief on the way to the quarterfinals. John John Florence, of course, now getting his best result of 2016 with a flow through to the semifinals.
We had like five or six lay days. We had a ton of lay days.
We ran up to find the other wave. There's a left up there. I spotted it with my own two eyes.
Oh! Look at that wave! A left, a right, a left, a right. That's all I wanted.
Rio's got such a crazy culture and just so much energy in the culture itself. There's a ton of stuff to do to keep you busy and just keep your mind in a good place.
John John Florence, a 13th at Bells Beach, a 13th at Margaret River. He's broken that now. He's into the semifinals here in Rio de Janeiro.
I kind of just went into it with the mindset, just like, I'm not going to think about him too much. I'm just going to surf.
Quick start now. Both surfers bringing opening scores to the panel.
They have made a major move. I mean, this is a completely different part of the beach. And that was all Adriano trying to find a different part of the bank. And now he's going to move again. And Adriano has jumped on the ski, gone 400 yards, 500 yards back. And now John sits by himself.
That actually ended up working to my advantage. He pulled me all the way down the beach, and I ended up getting a really good wave.
And now John John went down the coast. Yes, he'll come out of it. And John John Florence is going crazy in Brazil, and that was a nugget.
That kind of set my pace for that heat. Got right back out on the jet ski and got an 8 right after that.
And he's brought another cracker. John John Florence smokes Adriano de Souza here in semi-final number one. Is on his way to the final.
He just ended up playing that trick where he paddle all the way down and goes on the ski, and I was like, okay, well, I'll just try to get one, at least get something, and that thing was such a good double up.
Jack Freestone meets up with John John Florence for an exciting final.
I couldn't really hear the scores the whole beginning of the final, so I wasn't exactly sure what I had.
A couple of big whips on the forehand of John John Florence as he is heating up.
Just trying to play my game with it.
And I was just kind of holding priority because I had a pretty big lead.
Jack Freestone now in an 18.982 wave combination. Well, we thought it was difficult against Medina, and it's proving even more so against John John Florence.
He puts his hands up, it's official. Your 2016 Oi Rio Pro champ, John John Florence.
This win for me was really big. It starts my year off, essentially. It's like now I'm like up there, I'm in the title race, and feels like the real goal is at the end of the year.
Enjoyed the Brazil win for a little bit and just kind of rested. And then I started getting into Fiji and just real excited. It's fun, everyone's good friends. It's kind of just this family type thing that we all do every year. It's pretty cool, it's almost like a surf trip. It's at cloud break, it's like a 10-minute boat ride away from the island. It's really cool for the surfers because there's no one to commentate for. So all you're getting is just quiet. I surfed my first heat, then we had a lot of lay days.
Yes, big surfing, man. Big surfing, big surf. All right, nice, Suro. Woo, Vinaka John John.
I went with Kelly and John Roseman. And we went into the mainland, and all the families had a little kava thing set up at each house. And you'd go from house to house and drink a lot of kava, probably too much kava.
So much more than you think. So just rolling it.
Those guys are awesome, those guys are legends, and just to see how much Kelly puts back into the community, that was really awesome. Pretty inspiring for someone like me growing up and to just see what he's done with what he's made.
Okay. It's been really cool to work with Bede. There's so many different little things that could play into a heat. It's just cool to hear what he thinks about it because he's been on tour for a lot longer.
I knew the whole time I was going to have Taj this whole week. And it's Taj's last event. He's retiring after this amazing career. And he's one of my heroes since I was a little kid. And everyone wants Taj to win. And so this is going to be a really hard heat.
Taj is on an absolute screamer. Burrow wow. Is not holding back. The wave spits its guts out.
Wow.
What a cloud break special and a beautiful combo from the Hawaiian.
He's got nothing to lose. He's amped to surf. He's just having fun. We were just going back to back through the whole heat. I'd get a 9, then he'd get a 9, then I would get a 9. everyone wanted Taj to win, and even I wanted Taj to win, but it was hard because I was in the heat against him.
What a battle. John John Florence surfs the last heat ever against Taj Burrow as Taj Burrow makes it official and will be calling this a career. John moves on to round four.
He's been one of my heroes since I was a little kid, just inspiring me to be a competitor, inspiring me to be a free surfer, inspiring me to film things. I got Wilco in round four. He got me in that heat, and then I had a round five heat, and I made it to the quarters, and then I had Wilco again. He was just on such a good rhythm with such good waves, and he got me again.
This is gonna really sting for John. Things just not unfolding his way right now. It hurts, for sure. You gotta hand it to Matt Wilkinson, had a solid heat. He took care of business, and I don't think he feels bad at all.
If you lose, you're probably gonna learn something you wouldn't have learned if you won. That's kind of how I walked away with it, and I came home and I regrouped and got ready for South Africa. Every morning I was just running down there and just getting out there in the dark. I'd sit on the edge till first light came and try to get a couple waves. Lost my first heat and just didn't let it really bother me. I had a really good round two heat, just had a few good heats.
Feel super good to get through it. Stoked, everything's kind of clicking.
And then I had a really interesting heat against Jordy in the quarters. So woke up that morning, the waves were pumping. First light in the morning and they're just like, hey, starting, horn goes, heat starts and the waves just stop.
We have had a restart, so the surfer's getting set to hopefully tackle some set waves.
I kind of got stuck on one wave right away, and it was just a bad wave.
Check mark for Jordy. This is what he wanted.
Over 20 minutes, and the heat came all the way down to this, like, pretty much a 10-minute heat. I started taking off on smaller ones and just ended up getting a nice air in. And I see Jordy take off on a wave and do a turn and another turn, and I was like, okay. So I paddle and go over Jordy's wave and catch the very end of the next one.
And now he needs a backup. There's only 15 seconds to go.
And just do literally like a floater into like a whitewater climb.
And now he tries to stick the finish. He does that.
Coming off the beach and I'm like, okay, like, hope I got it. And then they announce it and I'm like, yes. Like, I just felt the emotion. I was just so stoked.
World titles are about overcoming tough situations like that, and John does just enough to get the victory.
So I'm the only one in the semis for a whole week.
They called the comp off right after that. For like another 3 or 4 days, we had lay days. Africa is one of my favorite places in the world. Going with my mom and my brother was awesome.
Amazing event it's been, and we have one more heat to decide a champion here at the J-Bay Open. John John Florence versus three-time world champ Mick Fanning.
Mick had everything going his way. He was on fire, he was surfing amazing, and so I was just kind of watching Mick, just observing the way he kind of went about it. And then I got my wave, and I got like an 8-5. I was like, yeah, okay, that was good. Like pretty amped, confident, and then Mick just got the best wave of the day and just surfed it perfectly and got like a 9.9.
Well, we are down to the final 50 seconds of this clash. And out the back, John Florence, he shakes hands with Mick Fanning.
I'm bummed I lost. I wish I would have won, but I'm happy with the way I surfed.
And now we have John John Florence moving into number two, within striking distance of Matt Wilkinson.
My whole goal right now is to try to win the world title. Got to get into a rhythm for the next event, and the next event, and the next event. It feels like the real goal is at the end of the year.
He's coming out! Look at him eating this. Look at this, right?
Yeah.
Who that guy?